Good morning, church. Today is December 2nd, Thursday. We are currently on day 5 of Bible reading, plan waiting for you, an Advent journey of hope. I just take a moment here, and can you guys believe that we are in the end of this year? December. It's December, right? Time flies, right? I feel like, you know, last month was January 2021, but now we are in end of this year. I hope and pray that those who are joining us today will remind themselves of God's love and His mercy and grace in 2021 for them through His Word, and they can find God's grace and greatness as well. The passages for today are coming from Psalms 46:10-11. I'll read it for you with ESV translation. Here's what it says. Be still and know that I'm God. I'll be exalted among the nations. I'll be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Amen. This is God's word. To finish the psalm, God himself speaks. Is he speaking to the nations or to his people? It's hard to tell exactly, but it seems to apply to both. In fact, God might just be speaking to all of creation, reminding us and them and the whole world that he alone is God. He alone is God, right? This reminds me of Jesus yelling at the wind and the waves in Mark 4:39, quiet, be still. Jesus could have been rebuking the demonic powers that stirred up the sea as well as the disciples' heart and mind, telling them all, right? I'm God. I have the power over all. So what God saves, what God says in Psalms 46:10 has sometimes been misread, I think. A common translation is, be still and know that I am God. This is not a bad translation, but we tend to hear God telling us to get quiet and still so we can hear his voice, or asking us to turn off our minds so he can reveal himself to us, or something similar. But there is a lot more going on here than just sitting in for a good quiet time or taking a meditation. There are two commands for us here, and they are tied together. The first tells us what not to do, and the second, what to do. The first has often been translated, be still. Other translations include stop fighting, stop your striving, or cease striving. Once again, and stop fighting, stop your striving, or cease striving. So my favorite dictionary of the Greek language says it means to be occupied or to stand empty. You know, God seems to be telling us to stop freaking out or to stop trying to fix everything since we cannot control it anyway. I picture myself standing before God with my head bowed and my arms and hands hanging limp, my shoulder hunched forward, whispering to God, I got nothing. And the Lord replying, it's about time. The Lord is telling us to give it up. So many of our worries and anxieties come from the deep root of thinking that we are supposed to fix everything, that it's our duty to tame any chaos in our lives. Not true at all. Not real, right? God is here rebuking our, you know, restlessness, our fretfulness, our self-centered hyperactivity, many things actually, like global pandemics, we have no control over. So we don't know what's going to happen, right? But we know something deeper and more rock solid. We know God. So I think so we are ready for the second command in verse 10. Know that I am God. You know, there is something deeper than the chaos and fear running rampant in our world. And we know Him, right? To know God is God means that we must acknowledge, recognize, and admit that God really is God over all. Once again, we have to admit that God really is God over all, everything, right? So we are not God. Our religious and political leaders are not God. Nature is not God. The virus is not God. Only God is God. And we know Him personally, right? Our God who is exalted and worshipped among the nation is also the Lord of armies and the God of Jacob. There has never been a time when God was not. Amen. There will never be a time when God is not. He is Lord, even over time. And He is powerful, commanding angel armies, and best of all, our powerful and in charge God is with us. Amen. He is for us. He is our stronghold. Once again, God is with us. He is for us. He is our stronghold. When I fear something, it helps me to think of the very worst of the worst thing that the thing could do. In this case, death. And then to realize that God has a plan, even for that resurrection from the dead, with Jesus Christ as our pioneer and example, then the fear begins to lose its power over me again. Not that I want to die, but if I do, God is still in control. He is the God of life. And if we know Him, we'll live even if we die. Amen. This is your prayer and, you know, the things make you confident. Even though so you die, no worry. You know, we will live because we know Him. We know Him personally. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much. Our God, our fortress, our Savior, our hope, and our powerful God. And you are God. You never, there is never a time when you were not God. There will be never a time when you are not God, Lord. You are always God. Thank you, Lord. And you will be with us forever and ever. This truth will make us confident that even though we are facing a death, because you have planned for us for that resurrection with Jesus Christ, everything is, including fear and even death, not makes us, you know, fear, but rather we can face everything with confidence because Jesus, you are God in control over everything. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. We now know that you are God. We can be still because we know you personally. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. In the precious name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.